All right, welcome back to the Podslice Daily. So, I was looking at my phone this morning, and it hit me. We spend our lives surrounded by these things. Your laptop, the server hosting this audio file right now. They all speak the exact same language. It's rigid. It's binary.
Yeah, it's a world of hard choices. Yes or no, on or off, just endless bits.
Right. But there is a revolution coming that suggests the universe isn't actually black and white. It's gray. It's messy. So today we are finally demystifying the big one, quantum computing.
Oh, man, quantum. It is such a buzzword. You see, it's slapped on everything now. Dishwasher tablets, bad sci-fi movies. It's a marketing gimmick half the time.
Oh, totally. But the reality? It's stranger than the fiction.
So strip it down for me, beyond the hype. If the computer I'm using right now is basically a billion little light switches, up for one, down for zero, what is a quantum computer?
Okay, so instead of the bit, you have the qubit, the quantum bit. And the best way to visualize this, stick with me, is a coin.
A coin?
Yeah. Picture a quarter sitting flat on this table, its heads or its tails. That is your classical computer. It's a definite state. It's stable. It's boring. But now imagine you flick that coin. Psh, it's spinning rapidly on its edge.
Okay, so it's just a blur of silver.
Exactly. Now, while it is spinning, is it heads or tails?
I mean, it's kind of neither. Or, well, it's potentially both.
Boom. It is effectively both at the same time. Until you slap your hand down on it to stop it, it exists in a cloud of probability. That is what physicists call superposition. A qubit isn't a one or a zero, it's a complex mix of both simultaneously.
Okay, but why does a spinning coin help me mine Bitcoin faster or crack a code? Why does the blur matter?
Because of the maze. This is where the math gets wild. Okay, imagine you're trying to find the exit to a massive complicated maze.
Okay.
Okay, a classical computer, the old heads or tails machine, is like a single mouse running through that maze. It runs down a path, hits a wall, turns around, runs down another path, hits a wall. It has to check every single route one by one to find the exit.
Right, brute force. It takes time.
Exactly. But a quantum computer, because of that spinning coin state, it doesn't send in one mouse. It sends in a million mice simultaneously. It floods the maze like water. It explores every single path at the exact same moment.
So it doesn't try one after another. It knows the layout instantly.
Basically, it finds the exit on the first try because it was everywhere at once. That's the power shift.
That is terrifying. But here's the question I always get from the risk side. Why now? We've had silicon chips for decades. They get faster every year. Why do we need to reinvent the wheel?
Because we're hitting a wall, a literal wall. You know Moore's law, right? Double the power every 2 years.
Yeah, the golden rule of tech stocks.
Well, it's dying. Manufacturers are shrinking transistors down to the size of mere atoms now, and that is where classical physics just, it breaks.
Breaks how?
It falls apart. When you get that small, electrons stop behaving. They start jumping across barriers they shouldn't. It's called quantum tunneling. It causes errors. So the industry realized if we can't beat quantum mechanics, we have to join them.
So instead of fighting the physics, we use the weirdness.
Right. Take Nature, drug discovery. This is massive for your pharma portfolio.
Go on.
Nature is quantum. Trying to simulate a complex molecule, take penicillin or even caffeine. That is incredibly hard for a standard computer. It chokes on the data. But a quantum computer, it speaks the same language as the molecule. It simulates those interactions naturally.
And we actually just saw this happen in the real world, didn't we, with Google?
Oh, the Willow chip. Yes. This is the news everyone is freaking out about. So Google's quantum team just published a paper in Nature. They used their new chip, Willow, to run something called the quantum echoes algorithm.
And the speed difference was frankly ridiculous.
It's insane. They clocked it at 13,000 times faster than the world's fastest supercomputer on specific physics simulations. 13,000 times! That is what researchers call verifiable quantum advantage.
Okay, but, and you know, I have to be the wet blanket here, investors need to read the fine print. I saw Sandra Pichai's comments on this.
He was cautious?
He was realistic. He basically tempered the expectations immediately. He said that a fully useful, error-corrected quantum computer, we're still looking at a decade or more away.
Yeah, because of the noise, right?
Exactly. These things are fragile. You look at the Willow setup. It requires extreme cooling. We're talking colder than deep space. And the qubits are unstable. So while 13,000 times faster is cool, if the error rate is too high, you can't run a bank on it yet.
That's fair. It's a marathon, not a sprint.
Right. But for pharma, for materials, the finish line is getting closer. But shipping back to risk, if the timeline is 10 years, that means we have 10 years to fix our encryption.
Ah, yeah, the quantum apocalypse.
We're seeing a massive race right now for quantum-resistant security. Because if you can solve the maze instantly, you can pick the lock instantly.
Exactly. It's a total arms race. If you want to really get into the weeds on this, specifically the timeline, because we aren't quite there yet, I'd recommend checking out the Joy of Why podcast. They have a great episode on the true promise of this tech.
Yeah, definitely worth a listen to cut through the noise. We'll be keeping our eye on the qubits.
Thanks for the chat, CryptoPod.
See you next time.